Good evening all and welcome to the YMCA Virtual Wellness Center. My name is Chuck, here to bring you yoga breath and meditation. Thank you for joining today. I often forget to tell you that I'm part of the YMCA DC, the branch up on W Street, and we're really, really happy to be able to bring this to you from Anthony Bowen YMCA. And there are many other great YMCAs as part of the Metro DC area. Class tonight, as many of you know, yoga breath and meditation, asanas for the body, the physical part that we think of yoga, those physical movements, little nidra, little relaxation, little pranayama, some focused breathing, and lastly, some easy guided meditation. And before we begin, we have a few things to remind ourselves about. Look around you, make sure you have enough room on each side, make sure you're safe. Listen to your body first, always. Listen to me second. Each week we do something a little different, and now we're doing sometimes just a little more challenging, but not too much. There should never be any pain. It should always feel good. Be kind to your body. And lastly, make sure that you have a little something to drink or a little something close by. You should always stay hydrated. In addition to this, I'd like to take a minute, and I'm sorry I have to read because I want to get it right, to remind you that we really appreciate your membership and support of the YMCA. So important. And right now, there's so many things that the YMCA branches are doing for you. They're distributing free produce each week to people in need across the community, providing emergency childcare for healthcare workers and people out there supporting our communities during these difficult times. They're supporting blood drives, helping our seniors stay connected, fit, and healthy, providing youth and families in need of critical services during this difficult time, and lastly, coordinating volunteer efforts throughout the community. So to learn more and to continue to support the YMCA efforts, please visit ymcadc.org. I hope you enjoyed today's class. It's about feeling good, and let's get ready to begin. Go ahead and roll your shoulders up and back and down a few times. Give yourself a few breaths, settle in. And then close your eyes with the shoulders back to the center and stump. And you could come to mudra, index and thumb together, palms up or palms down, you choose. And let's focus on the breathing, inhaling and exhaling through the nostrils, inhaling belly rising, exhaling belly falling. With every inhalation, feel yourself breathing in energy and positivity. Every exhalation, breathe out any tension or tiredness, and also really important, breathe out all thoughts of the day. Let everything go and just be here and now for our hour together. And during our time together, be kind to your body. Listen to your body first, listen to me second. But all of these things that we do together, especially in this class, are tools, tools to make our bodies, our minds, our spirits better, brighter. And before we use those tools, let's, in our mind's eye, in that space between the eyebrows, set an intention big or small. Set an intention and dedicate your practice toward bringing this intention to fruition. See your intention, take a moment, know what it is. And finally, bring hands to prayer as you slowly open your eyes. Thanks for joining this evening. You ready to breathe? Easy stuff. Inhale, prayer hands up. Exhale, float them out and down to the sides. Hands back to prayer. Always start with breathing. Inhale up. Exhale out and down to the sides. Hands back to prayer. One more time. Inhale up. Exhale out and down to the sides. Hands back to prayer. To each and every one of you, namaste. And thanks for joining this evening. Let's stretch the arms forward and sit even taller. Now inhale, open wide, look up, lift up, and reach the fingers up to the sky, bring in air and energy, but then exhale, let it go. Inhale, open up, look up, reach up, and exhale, let it go. One more time. Inhale, opening up, reaching up to the sky, bring in the energy, And exhale, let it go. And again, prayer hands, another hearty namaste to you all. All right, let's get to work. Go ahead and get your pillow or whatever you were using, maybe to sit comfortably out of the way. Let's get ready to roll down onto our backs. And as you do, bring your knees into your chest, hands on your knees. And start, as we always do, rocking a little side to side. Wake up your back, wake up your body, give yourself a little love. Moving, that's what's important. And as long as that feels good, coming back to the center and stop, gently squeeze the knees in. Make sure you look up to the ceiling as you bring both arms out to the side in T. You can do a 90 degree bend at the elbow, goddess or cactus pose, and then with a breath, inhale, exhale, both knees over and down toward the right elbow. And remember, closer to the elbow, more work, further away, a little lighter and easier. You choose what's right for you. And maybe the head continues to look up, or if it's okay, look out in the opposite direction to the fingers on the left hand. But then close your eyes and breathe, relax, breathe, let go. Enjoy this easy spinal twist. It should feel good. And let's continue. Inhale, head to center, exhale, belly tight. Inhale, knees to the middle. Exhale, both knees over and down toward the left elbow. Either looking up or maybe out to the right side. But once you're in position, close your eyes, breathe, relax. Breathe, let go, and feel good. And release it. Inhale, head to center, exhale, belly tight. Inhale, knees to the middle, reach up with both hands, catch a hold of the knees, squeeze it in one more time. Arms back out to the side in T, or goddess pose, head stays in the center. We get into a little swing with the breath. You ready? Knees. Inhale, exhale, over and down the right side and touch. Inhale, center with the knees and exhale, left. Inhale, center and exhale, right. Inhale, center and exhale, left. Inhale, center, exhale, right. Inhale, center, exhale, left. Inhale, the knees back to center and stop. Reach up with both hands, catch a hold of the knees and squeeze them in. Okay, feel good? Give me a thumbs up or a heart to let me know that you can hear me okay, that we're connected okay, and that you're feeling good. I want to make sure the music's not too loud. And let's get ready. Go ahead and inhale, stretch both legs up and out. Soles of the feet to the sky, tailbone down, thank you. Belly tucked, chin toward the chest. We'll do double leg stretches this evening. As you keep the tailbone down, you could inhale, raise the head up, hands on the legs, climb up, climb up, climb up, toes to the nose, heels to the sky, or if you have head or neck concerns, just rest the head back and down and gently draw the legs toward you. Something for everyone. Inhale, exhale, lower the head back down. I like to do two shorter ones. Let's do it one more time. Inhale, nose up, climb up, climb up, climb up, toes to the nose, heels to the sky. Stretch out those legs, breathe, and inhale, exhale, lower the head back down. Inhale, exhale, split the legs wide apart. Hands on the insides of the legs, flex the feet, draw those toes down toward the floor. Belly tight, inhale, raise the chest up, raise the head up, take a breath. Inhale, exhale, lower the head back down. Open up wide, draw those toes toward the floor. And again, inhale, come on up. Open up, look up, lift up. And inhale, exhale, lower the head back down. Bring the legs together. Knees into the chest, hands on the knees, squeeze in. As long as you're not with child, as long as the belly's feeling okay, press those thighs into the belly, flex your feet. Inhale, raise the head up, nose to the knees, give a good squeeze. Breathe. Inhale, exhale, lower the head back down. One more time, inhale, come on up. Nose to the knees, squeeze and breathe. Breathe and squeeze, press it in. And inhale, exhale, lower the head back down. Last one, and our nice, easy, smooth beginning. Split the knees wide apart. Happy baby pose. Flex your feet. Elbows to the insides of the knees. Raise up. Fingers to the outside of the feet. Lower the head back and down. Shine the soles of the feet to the sky. Take a few breaths. Working the thigh down to the floor. Knee to the foot perpendicular to the floor. And if you're feeling good, make it a rocking happy baby pose. Rock it out side to side. Rock it out, rock it out, rock it out. Don't be shy, rock it all the way over. The bigger the rock, the happier the baby. Rock it out, rock it out, rock it out. Another time or two. And slowly finish it and come back to the center and stop. Release the feet, bring the knees together. Knees into the chest, hands on the knees. Take a breath. Feel behind you as you slide the fingers behind the knees to rock up, or take it easy and just roll over to your side. Either way, safely, come on up to sitting pose. And let's flip it over to table pose. How are we doing, everybody okay? All right, and let's go from a neutral spine. You ready? Table pose, fingers spread wide, knees under the hips, and then with a breath, inhale, exhale, butt back and down, the heels, press the mat away with the palms, see if you get your butt cheeks to touch the heels, the forehead to touch the mat. It should feel good. So our warm-up is consistent in that we always include certain elements, and the next element is cat-cow. Come on and rise up. So last time we did those variations. So you know there's three ways to do this, right? All four on the mat, keep it simple. The goal, inhaling, concave spine, belly down, head up, tailbone up. Exhale, round the spine up and out, chin to chest. Or you could do one leg, inhale, lift up the toes, lift up the head and chest. It's still a concave spine. Exhale, chin toward the chest, knee toward the chin. And I have to go sideways to do this one, and you guys remember it, right? You could go long, inhale, toes up, fingers up, eyes up. Exhale, bring it closed. All right, those are your three options. I'm limited with space. I'm gonna start with all four on the mat. Let's do four together. You ready? Inhale, eyes up, belly down. Exhale, bring it closed. If you're doing the long one, remember opposite foot and leg. Opposite leg and arm. Inhale, eyes up, belly down. Exhale, bring it closed. Inhale, eyes up, belly down. Exhale, bring it closed. Inhale, eyes up, belly down. Exhale, bring it closed. Hand down, knee down, everybody. Inhale, exhale, butt back and down the heels. Wiggle the fingers, make a fist, roll the wrists around, give the hands a little love. Sometimes I'm thinking one thing and different words come out of my mouth. So those of you who know me, you know that happens on occasion, right? Let's go all fours. I'll try to do the long one with you this time. So what I meant to say the last time, one arm goes forward and the other leg goes back so that you're balanced. So one arm, mine is the left and my right leg's back. We inhale, lift up the eyes, lift up the fingers, lift up the toes. Exhale, bring it closed. Elbow on knee to chest, round the spine up and out. Inhale, concave spine. Exhale, bring it closed. Inhale, eyes up, belly down. Exhale, bring it closed. Inhale, stretch it out, lift it up, lift up the toes. Exhale, bring it closed, hand down, knee down. Everybody, inhale, exhale, butt back and down to the heels. Wiggle the fingers, make a fist, roll the wrists around, give the hands a little love. Hello, easy stuff, feel good? I hope so. Come on and rise back up to table. Take a few breaths. Okay, for tonight, I'm gonna do a couple different things. I want you to be kind to your body. And we've already warmed up the back, so we're gonna do our back work a little bit now. Usually I do that like second or third, but you've already been here with cat-cow, so we're gonna work a little bit with one-handed tiger pose. It's kind of cool, kind of fun. So we just warmed up the back, so we should be in good shape. So with this one, so you start by bending, and I'm gonna do the left knee first. Bend the knee and work the thigh up parallel to the mat and take the big toe up to the sky. Sometimes you look over the body, see where the leg is, make sure it stays in alignment with the body, and the thigh is parallel to the mat. Take the big toe up, lift it up, lift it up, lift it up. And then raise the head and chest so you get a little arch, right? This by itself is a perfect pose. If you can stay balanced, take that right hand back to find the left foot, catch a hold, and just balance and straighten out a little bit first. And then if you want to try to do the whole pose, press the foot into the hand, use the hand to lift up the foot, lift up the thigh, lift up the knee, raise the head and chest, make a little arch. Don't overdo it, it's Sunday. And inhale, exhale, release, hand down, knee down. Everybody, inhale, exhale, butt back and down to the heels. Wiggle the fingers, make a fist, roll the wrists around, give the hands a little love. All right, come on back up. I'll try to do it this way this time. Give me a different angle. All right, so fingers are spread wide. We're gonna take the right thigh up and take the big toe high to the sky. Lift it up, lift it up, lift it up. Look under the body. Try to get that right thigh parallel-ish to the floor. This is a perfect pose. You wouldn't have to do anything more, right? But if you want to add that final layer, reach back and find the foot. Take a moment, square the body to the mat. Press the foot into the hand and use the hand to lift up the foot. Raise the head up, raise the toes up. Take a breath. Smile because you know you love it. And inhale, exhale, hand down, knee down, everybody. Inhale, exhale, butt back and down to the heels. Wiggle the fingers, make a fist. Roll the wrists around, give the hands a little love. Good stuff. And go ahead and lie down on your back and give yourself a little breather. Knees into the chest, hands on the knees. Rock it out side to side. Rock it out, rock it out, rock it out. Come on back to the center and stop. Stretch out the legs. Give yourself a little breath. Feet and legs apart, arms away from the body, palms up and breathe. Big inhale, bigger exhale. Doing okay? All right, smooth and easy, keep it soft. So working a little more with the back this evening, so making the back strong. Those of you who know me, we've done this before. I call it clock pose because as you're resting on your back, I want you to imagine that you're on the face of a clock. With your legs straight in front of you, that's 6 o'clock. Your head's 12 o'clock. As you bring your arms out to the side in T, the right hand is 3 o'clock and the left hand is 9 o'clock. So imagine that you are the face of a clock. And now you're gonna do it really smooth and slow and easy. Bring those knees gently into the chest and your legs are about to become the second hand on the clock. A little bit of back work. Because we're gonna do some lifting, go ahead and press those palms down. So if you don't have them already, turn the hands over so the palms press down into the mat or floor. Be kind to your back, be kind to your body. Take it easy, you ready? Second hand of the clock is inhaling and exhaling, coming down toward 3 o'clock to the right side. And then as you stretch out the legs, slowly and carefully, they're coming down to 6 o'clock. And then as you come up to the left hand, 9 o'clock, you're bending in the knees. And as you come back to the center, you lift the legs up to 12 o'clock. All right? So you should not keep your head looking toward me. Look up to the ceiling, make sure you're kind of the head and neck, but you get the idea. So to keep it balanced, we go in the opposite direction. Inhale, exhale, knees over and down to the left side, 9 o'clock. We straighten the legs, they're low to the floor. We sweep down to 6 o'clock. We slowly bring the knees up toward the right side, 3 o'clock, and carefully inhale, rise back up, stretch out the legs to 12 o'clock. Big breath, inhale, exhale, lower the legs down, hands on the knees. So, one more time. If you have room, and it's a lot of work, you could keep the legs straight the whole time. Be kind to your back, be kind to your body. So you could do knees bent like we did just now, where only half is with the legs extended. Or if you want to do the whole pose, arms out to the side and T, palms down. Inhale, both legs up to the sky, 12 o'clock, right? You ready? Here we go. Inhale, exhale, both feet over and down toward the right hand, 3 o'clock. Hover low to the floor, sweeping down to 6 o'clock. I don't have room, so I have to bend my knees, otherwise your legs are straight. Feet coming out toward the left hand, 9 o'clock, and inhale. All the way up to 12 o'clock, take a breath. And last one in the opposite direction. Inhale, exhale, both feet over and down to the left hand. Hover low to the floor as you sweep the legs down to 6 o'clock, straight in front of you, just a few inches above the floor if you can do it. Inhale, feet back up to the right hand, 3 o'clock, and inhale, both legs back up to 12 o'clock. Bend in the knees, catch a hold with both hands. Squeeze the knees in. Give yourself a little side to side rock. Good work, everyone. Stretch the legs out and down. Give yourself a little breather. Relax. Big inhale. Bigger exhale. Another big breath. Very good. Take a breath. Slowly roll over onto your side. Come on back up to table pose. Inhale, exhale, butt back and down to the heels. Just stretch out one more time. That child's pose or stretching out, fingers pressing the mat away, butt cheeks working the way down toward the heels, forehead working the way down toward the mat. Smooth and easy? I hope so. It's supposed to be. Okay, so now with a breath, separate those fingers, spread the hands wide, rise back up to table. Make sure you have enough room. I do not. There's a wall right here. We're going to jackknife into down dog, tailbone high to the sky, and walk the dog. Bend one knee while pressing the other heel back and down. Walk it out, stretch it out, make it feel good. Come on back to a static or holding down dog. One time, inhale up on the tiptoes, tailbone high to the sky. Exhale, heels back and down, head and chest back and down. Breathe. And finish it by walking your hands back to meet your feet. Drop the head down low, tighten the belly, and inhale, slowly roll your way on up to standing pose. Shake it all out. How are we doing, everybody? Okay? Roll the shoulders up and back and down. So, I'm trying to slowly work our way off the mat and come to some standing poses. We did one last week, and for tonight, what I'd like to do is simply tree pose. If you like Sanskrit terms, it's Vrikasana, but tree pose, it's about balance. It's about balance on one leg and foot, and I'm sure you've done it before. Some variations with me. So it's really the balance that matters more than anything, and if all you can muster is up on one toe, it's a beautiful tree. Maybe you can put the foot on the shin and you need tree arms. Perfect. Or two choices, the classic pose, bring the foot high above the knee to the inside of the thigh. Knee comes out to the side, hips are open. You're here or here. And I got one more variation, all right? Some of you are fancy. Some of you are fancier than I am. Half lotus. I actually like this one too. It's simply lifting the sole of the foot up so it goes to the sky. Oops, glad there's a ball there. And the knee comes down. All right. You do something like that, and depending on what you're wearing, you either can hold on to the foot or bring both arms up. So, options. Shake it out. Separate the feet hip width apart. Close your eyes for a moment. Close your eyes and breathe. Come down mentally to the feet. Breathe, be grounded through the feet. Scan up through the legs, the torso, the body. Breathe, be balanced in body. Lastly, scan up to the neck, the head, and the crown of the head, and breathe. Be centered in mind, grounded, balanced, centered. That's how you make a good tree. I'm going to do classic pose in the first one. Press your left foot firmly down, belly tight, buttocks tight. Use a drishti. A drishti is a focal point somewhere on the wall in front of you, something that's not moving. Helps keep the mind steady, helps you maintain the balance. When you're ready, rise up to the pose that you want to do. You might need prayer hands, maybe tree arms, or if you can rise up. Fingers reach, shoulders relax, arms alongside the ears. Keep your belly tight and breathe. And see if you can hold the pose for a few breaths. Breathing, focusing, holding your balance. That's all that matters, wherever you are. I wish I could see you because I know you're doing a great job. If you're in this classic pose, keep that right knee out to the side with the hip open. Belly tight, buttocks tight, breathing. You can hold this as long as you want, but for now, slowly inhale, exhale, come on down. A kick out to the side for good luck, and shake it out. Shake out the feet, shake out the legs. Sway a little side to side. Come on back to the center and stop. Separate the feet. Big inhale. exhale. All right. So for the next round, I'm going to demonstrate and do the half locust version. Again, about three or four options, even more than that. Find one that works for you. It's the balance that matters. Drishti, right foot firmly down. Whichever one you choose, rise up into the pose. Make sure you're breathing. Use your drishti. Find your balance. Find your space. You could continue prayer hands, tree arms, or you could grow your tree tall. Hold and breathe. Stay focused on your drishti, that focal point on the floor or wall in front of you that doesn't move. Breathing. Belly tight, buttocks tight, just holding the pose. You know you're in the perfect pose. When you get there and you feel like you could stay there for a very long time. But for now, let's leave the pose. Inhale, exhale, prayer hands. Little kick to the side for good luck. And lower down. And separate the feet and sway with me a little bit. All right, good stuff, everyone. And come on down to the mat and stretch out the legs. How are we doing, everybody? Okay? All right, I hope so. I look forward to the day that we can see each other again in class. I enjoy being with you for our virtual class very much, but seeing your smiling faces and just being with you, I look forward to the day that we can do that again very, very soon. All right, so lift and tilt, lift and tilt. Good staff pose. Butt cheeks come behind you. On the front side of the sits bones, press down, toes to the nose, good staff pose. Press those palms down, just a little exaggerated. Belly in, squeezing the shoulder blades, lifting up. It's a really strong seated pose, simply your foundation for all of our forward stretches. Okay, take another breath. And now let's get ready. We're gonna work a little bit with some forward stretches. Inhale, let's rise up. Fingers all the way to the sky. Lift up, lift up, lift up. Inhale, exhale, forward to the wall in front of you. Let the fingers go out to the wall, hollow out the belly, roll the belly up and back. Inhale, exhale, lower the hands down. Could be on the mat, could be on the legs, could be on the toes. And now I want to be able to see you, so I'm going to face you. Sorry about the soles of the feet. We'd never do that in India, would we? Soles of the feet towards you, not the right way to be. But I want to be able to see you. So roll the belly up and back. Literally roll the belly up and back. And draw the toes to the nose. You're massaging those internal organs. You're stretching out the hamstrings. Lots of options. Hands on the mat. Or classically, you'd have the index and thumb around the big toe. Just gently drawing the toes toward the nose. Hold on where you are. Inhale, look up, grow the spine and make it a little longer. Inhale, exhale. Lower the belly down. Maybe lowering the chest down. Lastly, chin, nose, forehead. But continue to make the chest the lowest point down because there's no prize in getting the head down to the mat. You don't want to strain the shoulders or the neck. Let the chest be the lowest point down. Breathe. And as you hold the pose, you've heard me say it so many times before, anything we do together, find something you like. Take it, practice it on your own, and hold it longer. Our time goes quickly. And with something like a forward stretch, as you hold it, as you continue to hollow the belly, as you continue to draw the toes to the nose, you can inhale, exhale, just sink down another 1/16 of an inch more. Breathing. Very nice. And to release, stretch the arms forward, palms facing. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, float the mat and down to the sides. Hands on the thighs. Big inhale. Bigger exhale. Another big breath. Very nice. And relax and shake out the legs a little. Okay, got one more fun one. We've done it before. If you know me, we've done probably a bunch of times. Bring the soles of the feet together like we're going to come into Buddha Konasana or Butterfly Pose. Bring the heels a little closer toward the groin. You bounce the knees a little. We're not actually going to do that pose. It's just our starting point. All right. So, we do lotus flower. It's a nice balance. Before you do it, look behind you. Make sure there's nothing dangerous, like a big wooden credenza, like I have. Make sure whatever is behind you, if you lose your balance, if you roll back, it's not gonna hurt. If you crash back into something hard, it might. And here's how we begin. Pick up one foot, index and thumb. There's half. And then slide down, pick up the other foot. Bring the heels together, draw the toes apart. You have your little index and thumb together, palms up, your mudra. You're balancing, you're holding, you're breathing. And if you are creative, you can imagine that you are a lotus flower. And you know one of the reasons why lotus flowers are so beautiful in so many ways, but they come from the muck, the bottom, the water, a place where no one actually would think something so beautiful could ever arise from. So I think in some of the spirituality where the lotus is such an important flower, it's a little bit of a metaphor, right, for all of us, that we can rise up and become something very beautiful. We just need to give ourselves time to focus on it, to make it happen. All right, if you're still there, let's release it. Inhale, exhale, lower down. Stretch out the legs. Roll your shoulders up and back and down. Having you hold a pose while I give you my philosophy on something is probably not a good thing. You should come out of the pose. All right, enough good work for tonight. Go ahead and scoot your butt forward, rolling down onto the mat one more time. Good work, everyone. I hope you had a good Sunday today. We're rocking side to side with the knees. Rock it out, rock it out, rock it out. Come on back to the center and stop. One more time, arms out to the side in T, the way we always begin. We finish, inhale, exhale, both knees over and down to the right side. Head to the left, close your eyes, breathe, relax. Breathe, let go. Breathe and let go. And continue it by inhaling, head to center, exhale, belly tight, inhale, knees the middle. And exhale, both knees over and down to the left side. Looking out in the opposite direction with the knees. Or looking up. But close your eyes. Breathe and relax. Breathe and let go. Nice. And continue. Inhale, head to center. Exhale, belly tight. Inhale, knees to the middle. And lastly, with your arms alongside the body, inhale, raise both legs up and out. Soles the feet to the sky. Tighten the belly, lead with the heels, and slowly lower the legs down to the floor in front of you. And when you are down, relax and release. Feet and legs apart, arms away from the body. Palms up and breathe. Big inhale, bigger exhale. Another big breath. Good work, everyone. Few different things, mixing it up a little bit this evening. You remain resting on the mat. You remain resting on the mat as you lie on the mat, focusing on the breath, inhaling and exhaling through the nostrils. You are resting down on the mat with all of your asanas complete through the practice of the asanas. Those physical postures, we work to grow and flow the prana, the energy. Now we let the physical body rest as you are lying on your mat, resting with feet and legs apart, arms away from the body. Get comfortable. If you have anything that needs to be moved, move it and get it out of the way. And now we move to our nidra, a mini relaxation. The yogic theory is through the asanas, you work to grow and flow the prana, the energy. Now we let that physical body work, we put the energy body to work. We spread this energy throughout the body just by focusing and bringing your attention to these different parts of the body. Energy following thought, or it simply feels really good to relax and let go. So, gather up all your focus and attention. Bring it down to the feet and toes. observing the feet, the toes, the skin, muscle, down the bone, down to the very center of the bone. And as you deeply observe your feet, say to yourself, my feet are relaxing. My feet are relaxing. Breathe deeply into the feet and feel your feet relaxing. Feel your feet letting go. Move your focus from the feet to the ankles, to the calves, the shins, the knees, the thighs, the hips. This time deeply observing your legs. Say to yourself, my legs are relaxing. My legs are relaxing. Breathe deeply into the legs. Feel the legs relaxing. Feel the legs letting go. And then move your focus to the torso and move to the backside, observing buttocks, lower waistline, lower back, scanning up the sides, mid-back, shoulder blades, neck and shoulders. Tell it all to relax. Tell it all to let go. And then move your focus back around the front side and scanning from the hips into the pelvic area and up across the abdominals, across the belly, up the sides, again up across the chest, the neck and shoulders. And include the arms, so mentally scan from the shoulders down the arms to the elbows, from the elbows down the hands and fingers. So this time deeply observing your body, say to yourself, my body is relaxing. My body is relaxing. Breathe deeply into your body. Feel your body relaxing, letting go. And lastly, scan up the neck and throat, up to the mouth and tongue. Relax your jaw, slightly separate your teeth. Relax the lips. Relax the cheeks. Deeply relax the eyes. As you focus your attention on the eyes, imagine and feel them warm and liquid, like they're sinking back into the skull. Relax the nose, relax the ears, the temples, the forehead, and up across the crown of the head and down the back of the head and neck. So this time, deeply observing your entire being, say to yourself and really feel it. Say to yourself, I am relaxing. I am relaxing. Breathe deeply into your entire being and deeply relax, deeply let go. And so you can enjoy this feeling of relaxation. One more time, behind closed eyes, rest your gaze, rest your focus upward and center to the space between the eyebrows. And use your creative mind to see that space, warm and luminous, light and open. Just kind of sink in. Don't wander away. Breathe and enjoy a moment or two of rest. Resting and breathing, the mind upward and centered. And if you find yourself wandering away, because it's hard to keep the mind steady and still, maybe this recording, I am, maybe you can simply mentally repeat yourself, I on the inhale, am on the exhale, and allow that easy little mantra slowly further clear out the mind, keep you fully here and present so you don't wander away. Follow the breath, follow the I am for one more moment. allowing your bodies to feel light, open, and energized, and allowing your minds to feel a little lighter, clear, refreshed. So in a moment, for the next part of class, we need to make our way up to sitting pose. We do it really slowly. And as you do, breathe and find your fingers and toes and move them. Breathe, find your hands and feet and move them. And breathe, find your arms, legs. Stretch out with a big inhale. You could get long. Stretch out. Roll over to your side. Give yourself a sweet pause on the side, taking your time. And when you're ready, slowly push your way up to sitting pose. Finding that comfortable sitting pose. I use a pillow. I find it helpful to lift my tailbone a little higher. The knees are a little more comfortable. You could sit simple, easy pose or cross-leg, kind of most classic pose. I do a seated diamond, heel to the groin, foot alongside the shin. So there's more of this wide diamond shape with the knees, the hips, tailbone. Some of you fancy people, if you like the idea of a half lotus, you can certainly do that as long as the knees are down, as long as you're not killing your ankle. And certainly if you're really fancy, you could do lotus pose. And I'm not going to do that for you right now because mine doesn't look that pretty. The goal, long, tall spine, grounded, chest high and open, roll the shoulders, be comfortable. You might even need to sit in a chair, and that's absolutely fine if you do. Feet firmly on the floor, feet hip-width apart, feet under the knees. Mudra, as you've heard me say before, a concept of theory. Palms up, needing more energy. Palms down, needing to be more grounded. And then close your eyes, and let's focus on the breathing as we now move toward our pranayama. So if you've been with me before, you know our base pranayama is that three-part yogic breath, super easy, inhaling, belly rising, chest rising, upper chest filling, and imagine if you can, exhaling, emptying upper chest, and belly. But the valve is only half open, so you slowly sip the air in, so it takes a while to fill belly, chest, upper chest, and equally slow as you exhale, emptying upper chest and belly out and down. You can even pull the belly button in at the end of the exhalation. Continue your three-part yogic breath as we lay the foundation. Slow and full all the way up, and slow and complete all the way out and down. See if you can slow that breath down. The breath is an incredibly powerful tool. Even this simple breath, following this breath, a doctor's appointment, a dentist appointment, if we ever get a chance to be back on an airplane again when you have that bumpy flight, using your breath, such a great tool that we don't use often enough. To slow down the body, to slow down the mind, to get us relaxed, calm, and centered. And with this foundation, our three-part yogic breath, we add a layer. I've been trying to do some different layers with you each week, but I want to go back to our alternate nostril breathing, or Nadi Sudhi. So powerful, so effective. Some of you who've practiced it before, you can do it without the hand in place. It's the focus on the nostril. But for most of us, myself included, we need that little physical aid. So, alternate nostril breathing. Bring your right hand up, take the middle finger and the index, place it to the center space between the eyebrows. Bend in the ring and pinky finger, your bent ring finger. I told you sometimes I can't talk. It's the valve for the left nostril. The thumb is for the right nostril. So your hand rests on your face like a little mask. All right. And what we do is, with Nadi Sudhi, we do alternate nostril to the count of six, or your count, but the goal is to keep that full three-part breath employed throughout the whole process. We'll get synchronized with one big inhalation through both nostrils. Let's do it together. One big exhalation through both nostrils. Close your right nostril, inhale left. Two, three, four, five, six. Close left open, right exhale. Two, three, four, five, six. Inhale right, two, three, four, five, six. Close right, open left, exhale. Two, three, four, five, six. Inhale left, two, three, four, five, six. Close left, exhale right, two, three, four, five, six. Inhale right, two, three, four, five, six. Close right, open left, exhale, two, three, four, five, six. Inhale left, two, three, four, five, six. Exhale right, two, three, four, five, six. Inhale right, two, three, four, five, and six. And close right, exhale left, two, three, four, five, six, and bring the hand down. Big inhale, big exhale, and rest your gaze fully upward and centered again to the space between the eyebrows. Give yourself a moment. Allow the body to feel very light and open, the mind calm and centered. And as you focus upward and inward, simply see light. See light and be light. And hold yourself. Behind the alternate nostril breathing or Nadi Sudhi is you're further balancing the energies. In the theory, one nostril is an energy channel Ida, the other Pingala, and those are the masculine and feminine. Again, I can't talk masculine and feminine energies, and it's getting this balance between the two that further brings the body into stillness. Brings the energy body into balance and brings the mind to stillness and to be centered. But it's the experience that matters. So many words, so many theories, so many ways to describe it. What matters is that you have and feel the experience. So through this practice of asanas, nidra, and pranayama, you set this perfect stage for meditation. And if you've been with me before, you've heard me say, final piece before meditation is concentration. And there's fancy Sanskrit words for each of these aspects. But for you, you've already been concentrating each time you rest your gaze upward and centered, focusing the mind. Our meditation starts guided because we need to further still and quiet the mind, and we end silent. Classic meditation, there's no talking, there's no music. But we need these little extra things to set the mood, to set and bring the right energy. Ultimately, stillness, both in and out, is what we're after. We began our meditation as we always do, looking upward and inward and imagining and seeing light. imagining and seeing light. And as you look upward and inward, look deep on the inside, and deep in the center, right in the middle, is a pinpoint of brilliant light. Use your creative mind to see, find, create this pinpoint of brilliant light. Small, bright, maybe even a light blue hue of light, but it's your light. Let it be what you see, find, and create. And gather all your focus and attention and breathe. And as you look inward and see, find, create this pinpoint of brilliant light, move yourself in and down, closer to this light and energy. And breathe and gather all your focus and attention and move in and down closer to this pinpoint of brilliant light and energy. Breathe and move yourself in and down closer yet to this pinpoint of brilliant light, the center of your being, the source of your light, the source of your energy. And lastly, using your super creative mind, breathe and move yourself in, down, and through this light. And suspend yourself in your light and energy. Hold yourself there. Imagine your entire being surrounded with your light and energy. Keep the mind still and focused inward. If you start to wander away, mentally go in and see, find, create that pinpoint of light and repeat the process. Breathe and hold yourself here for a few moments of stillness. Don't wander away. Enjoy this time. Breathe. Beautiful. Bodies light, open, energized. Minds cleared, lightened, focused. And it's here in your quiet center where you come to the very beginning of meditation. A lot of ways to get here, many theories. This is just one. Many reasons to come here. Coming to meditation is a place to heal yourself physically, emotionally, spiritually. Coming to meditation is a way to hit the reset button. Find a way where you can come to stillness and clear out the mind on a regular basis, because what happens is the more you do it, you create this little steady undercurrent of peace, of calmness. And each time you practice, you add a little more strength to that undercurrent. So as all the crazy things of our lives come and go, we have some baseline of peace, some baseline of stillness, some consistent level that carries us through. And with your meditation practice, you'll find that as you practice, the longer you'll want to be in meditation. When you sink into this still place, you'll find that you miss it if you don't come to it. So find a little time, make it part of your day, practice every day. Now, let's get ready to finish. Take a nice big inhale, give yourself a bigger exhale. Breathe and find your hands and fingers and move them. Breathe, find your arms, your shoulders, move them. Breathe, find your head and neck and move. And slowly bring prayer hands to heart center and rest the thumbs on your breastbone. Close your eyes again. We have some creative stuff we need to do. Using our minds in a creative way, go deep on the inside and find your light and energy. We're going to draw some of it up and out. Breathe and use your creative mind. And as you found that light deep on the inside, draw some of that light and energy up. Being super creative. Breathe and move some of your energy up and out. And bring it up to that space between the eyebrows, almost shining it out brightly, like a light from the inside. First, call back your intention, your dedication. Surround it in your light and energy and take a moment to see your intention or dedication fulfilled and satisfied in every way. See it as a still image, see it as a little movie playing, hear or see the words, but see your fulfilled intention, complete, satisfied, and surround it in your light and energy and make that fulfilled intention your reality. And then gathering up a little more light and energy, some of your goodness that we manifest from the inside so we can share it out to people who need it most. Open up the palms of your hands, send out your goodness, your intention, catch it in the palms of your hands. Being super creative, feeling the power of your light and energy, feeling the power of your fulfilled intention. And with one big breath as we close, we inhale, look up, reach prayer hands high to the sky, and when you open up your hands, send out your light near and far to people who need it most. Send out your fulfilled intention to every corner of the universe. And lastly, bring hands to prayer. And I say to each and every one of you one more time, namaste. Thank you guys for being here. So good to be with you again. Can't wait to be with you again in person at the Anthony Bowen YMCA on W Street in Northwest or someplace sometime real soon. Be safe, stay healthy. Continue to do and think positive thoughts. If you like our class, make sure you give it a heart, give it a thumbs up, Make sure you like the site for ymcadc.org and our virtual wellness center. Please continue to support the Y and all the efforts that so many people continue there. And I'll see you on Thursday night at 6 o'clock. Thanks for coming. Stay safe. Have a good week. Coming in for my close-up, which is always a little frightening. Bye, guys. See you soon.